I barely touched any of it. I'm sure that whatever minor alteration may have occurred will go completely unknown. I could be any kid running a time machine. See? My hair is completely different. Enough talk. I know you are the one who changed the garage code. I need Uncle Duck. What's the garage code?
Flash. Right. Thanks.
Oh, no! Carl! Somebody's stealing the time machine!
Me, Carl.
Some guy in the
bowler hat.
Ah, great. They're gonna find some way to blame me for this.
Right. And do you want to know what else isn't funny? Giant ant stole the time machine. We're all wound up. Let's just calm down, take a breather, and watch the sunset. I'm on it. Carl, I barely touched anything. I'm sure that whatever minor alteration may have occurred will go completely unnoticed. I could be any kid running a time machine. See? My hair is completely different. Enough talk. I know you are the one who changed the garage code.
And me, Uncle.
So, what's the garage code?
Flash. Right. Thanks.
Oh, no! Carl! Somebody's stealing the time machine!
Me, Carl. Some guy in the bowler hat.
Ah, great. They're gonna find some way to blame me for this. Right. And do you want to know what else isn't funny? Giant ant stole the time machine. You're all wound up. Let's just calm down, take a breather, and watch the sunset. I'm on it.
All began in a faraway place called Zanzibar, across the bay from the city of Dar es Salaam, in East Africa. This is Zanzibar before the trouble started. The lazy island is the tropical Indian Ocean. For as long as anyone there can remember, the people have always raised spiny clothes and been ruled by sleepy soldiers. The latest and greatest of them all was the Sultan Majid. The Sultan enjoyed his power because he truly cared for his people. He kept them busy and prosperous by building the biggest clove industry in the whole world. The harbor of Zanzibar was not very deep, so ships had to anchor far from the shore. Daring to stand in his way. Clouds he had to destroy at all costs.
¿Quiere usted decir que debo atender a los animales, no importa de qué especie sean? Aún no estaré preparado por si él viene. Doctor, no se preocupe.
Pero
con esta fotografía no me será difícil reconocer al lobo Hoagy. El lobo Hoagy. Ya tengo referencias suyas. Estoy enterado que le gusta que lo atiendan gratis, pero no me sorprenderá. Largo. Oiga, Sanitis. Caracoles. Creo haber leído algo acerca de eso en la revista médica. Esta es una nueva enfermedad. ¿Los síntomas son de fatiga? ¿Se siente usted bien? ¿Puede hablar? ¿Siente vértigo? ¿Se le doblan las rodillas? ¡Eso es holgazanitis! ¡Es terrible! ¡Espere! ¡Deténgase! Usted es un hombre enfermo, te quiero decir un lobo. Lo oí quejarse, ¿le duele algo, amigo? Correcto, quiere comer un pollo a la cacerola con papas fritas, champiñones y con poca grasa. ¿Qué desea tomar? No, eso no se lo puedo permitir. Está enfermo y debe permanecer aquí.
¿Sí?
Qué resignado es, quiere distraerse sabiendo que está tan enfermo. No conozco ningún medio para curar la holgazanitis, pero sin embargo, puedo operarlo. Es la única forma en que puede sanar. Además, si no muere, seré un médico famoso. Siempre he deseado operar a alguien, y ahora puedo hacerlo. Esta es mi gran oportunidad.
I passed a school one day in LA that said art and soul. And I just thought, maybe that would make a good title. Just about every album I've done, I've always done some, as you say, interpretations or covers. And this was the first time I really got a chance to do a whole album of them. And initially, I thought it would end up being just songs from the 60s. But the way it turned out, it kind of moved up through the years to, when you're as old as I am, his style is pretty much in place. So there have been some of these songs which were hard to do because, I mean, you know, you take a song like What's Going On from Marvin Gaye. It's so beautiful. I mean, you know, it's very hard to top it, you know what I mean? So you're looking for a bit of a different kind of integrity to put over it. Because the arrangements aren't that different. But yeah, the inner approach was different. It was hard, you know, we started off in LA with the sessions. And this time around, I've done albums before. I did when the earthquake came to LA last time. And this time the fires were in LA. And you know, we were calling them the fire sessions for a while because, I mean, you can hear a certain dryness in my voice. There was ash fall, and it was dark. It was a real good time. You know, at night I would drive back to this place we had in Valencia. See the freeway on fire. You know, so it's kind of good. The first few tracks we put out was very haunting. And that was, I noticed my timbre in my voice. Space as small as this with his board and the booth, you know. So it was I felt very little intrusion, and I was able to just kind of go off into my, you know, to my own world.
Get off my lawn, trespasser! Do you want to be eaten alive? Then get out of here! Stay away from my house! You think you can just terrorize my lawn? Gonna be a dead person? This place is not a playground for children! This is my house! Why can't you respect that? Why can't you just stay away from...
believe what happened. There was this poor old bag lady, and she left her bag behind, and I saved her life.
Okay, gang, 5 o'clock, everybody in the zoo, rise and shine. Hit the deck, members. On your feet, Wally. Ready for your exercise. And a one, two, 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 oh! And you remember what we always say? Forget it. Here, here, where do you think you're going? Come back, Wally. It's against the rules to run away.
Of course, my dear. Wait till you taste it. Excellent vintage. Sacre Bleu, 1920. Oh, yes. That's what we're having. Is there something wrong?